Welcome back. We are learning to solve some of the projectile types of the problems, and we have calculated time, height and range of the projectile. So we have calculated these three factors which are involved in case of projectile motion. Now we are discussing another topic, that is displacement of summit point from the point of projection. So here it is, the maximum height gained by a projectile is this one, 300 meter. If it travels a range of 800 meter, find the displacement of the summit point from the point of projection. So here it is, you are given maximum height, you are given horizontal range. So basically this maximum height is half of the range, that is OC will be equal to 400 meter. Then by using Pythagoras theorem, what it is OC square, that is equal to OA square, that is equal to OC square plus CA square. We are asked to calculate the distance. So after putting the values, when you reaching up to the maximum height, it is 400 square, 300 square, and this will be the distance of the summit point. If you draw the point, this is basically like this. This is the maximum height, H max. This is the maximum height. This is the maximum height, and here it is. This is the maximum height again. What you are given is maximum height 300 meter. So it is 300 meter, and the range is 800 meter. It means half of the range will be 400. Here it will be 400 meter. And then you are asked to calculate the displacement of the summit point. So this will be the displacement of the summit point. So it is, if this one is O, this one is A, and this one is C, then it is equal to OA square, that is OC square plus CA square. So this is basically perpendicular base square plus perpendicular hypotenuse square, that is equal to base square plus perpendicular square. Why you have taken 4? Because this will be the half. When you're reaching at a maximum height, the range will be the half, that is half of 800 is 400. So after putting the values of 300, the values of OC and CA, so you have calculated that displacement from this point to this point, reaching up to this point. So with this, today's topic ends. I thank you very much for your patience. Hope you people have understood, and you have understood to solve the problems of projectile motion and momentum and uniform type of the motion. Thank you very much.